Tony, there are two groups. The Fed is organized. The Fed is providing stability. And the overnight market surge we've seen in repo is no big deal. There's another camp that says baloney. The world's falling apart. Which is it? Bring the chart up, Brad, for TV and on radio. All you need to know, it's a spike like you've never seen. Think about Jeff Bezos going up in space. That's what the spike looks like. Tony, what's it mean?
Well, it's as if the Fed wrote its recent framework on disappearing ink to some, because the Fed's new framework released last August 27 said that it wouldn't raise its policy rate until the inflation rate had gone above its 2% target for some time. It hasn't really done that for some time, and so hence the idea of disappearing ink. This spike we're seeing in rates, of course, relates to the Fed's communication. And I should add that Ben Bernanke, who's an advisor to PIMCO, has famously said that Fed policy is 2% action, 98% communication. It goes to show how strongly markets take the words of the Federal Reserve, and certainly they were taken very strongly. So the rise in rates, I would say that it's as if the Fed is put the inflation cop back on the beat. It wanted to regain control of the inflation narrative because the public's hype over inflation had gotten too high. The Fed got spooked. That's what it says.
Okay.
And it'll probably be good. Final words, Tom, on this. It'll probably be good for the equity market, for the credit markets, private investments, including real estate, because it looks like it will rein in the inflation fears.
Right.
The Fed may.
But Tony, this is really important. If Crescenzi's telling me the Fed got spooked, that's really, really important. What about the responsiveness, the malleability, the dynamics, the elasticity of trillions of dollars? I don't understand the theoretical model of what that money does that came from this pandemic.
Well, we see $750 billion of it in a Fed repo facility. There's still a lot of money sloshing around, and it's the reason why the Federal Reserve raised a few official policy, I shouldn't say technical policy rates that it tracks. It has its official policy rate, of course, is around zero, but it does things to tweak behavior in the money markets. And last week, it raised two specific rates by 5 basis points because there's so much money floating around that it was putting downward pressure on money market rates, call it commercial paper, et cetera, and 3-month LIBOR, which reached an all-time low of 13 basis points last week. And so there's still that money still is out there, so to speak, and it won't be removed for a long time. Remember, the Fed is still purchasing $120 billion of new securities per month. In other words, it's printing another $120 billion of money each month. It'll do so into next year, and it won't shrink its balance sheet for a while. Why? Because it's going to reinvest the principal and interest payments it gets on the mortgages it has and the treasuries
okay,
it
but,
has.
But,
and,